What you just witnessed was the lengths a dog owner is willing to go in an effort to save her dog. This is in Los Angeles, and unfortunately, there's been this ongoing trend of dog nabbers basically stealing Frenchies because they're pricier dogs that can be resold. And so a woman by the name of Ali Zacharias was caught on camera clinging to the hood of a car in downtown Los Angeles on January 18th after another woman snatched her French bulldog who goes by the name of Onyx. And this was just outside of Whole Foods. So there's the French bulldog, and this particular French dog, a French bulldog, Onyx, is a rarer kind because of the coloring and the fact that Onyx has two different eye colors. And the price of these dogs is insane, okay? Like upward of $7,000. So you can, I don't wanna say understand why these thieves would try to steal these dogs, because I don't understand it. I think it's disgusting and these people should be prosecuted to the highest extent of the law, okay? Maybe life in prison without the possibility of parole.
Well, I'd bring that down a little bit.
Maybe not.
Okay, but guys, I do wanna say something. I know it's a little off topic, but you know, there is a distinction here. Like, we can condemn what they're doing completely. But yes, Anna, like they're stealing these particular type of dogs because they're expensive. That's why they're doing it. It doesn't justify that they're doing it. I just wanted to say that because a lot of times people say about with terrorism too, like, oh wow, we can't understand it at all. No, it could be terrible, but we understand the thought process that went into why they did the terrible thing. It doesn't excuse it at all. And in this case, stop stealing people's dogs. But since these are very expensive, be careful because there are people looking to steal them.
So Ali Zacharias, that's the dog owner, said that she was just sitting outside of the Whole Foods having lunch. She's with her French bulldog on a leash. And apparently a woman approaches her and grabs Onyx's leash and then begins walking to the getaway car. And Zacharias, poor Zacharias. Poor naive Zacharias, not realizing the Los Angeles she's currently living in. Because back in the day, this wouldn't happen, right? There's tons of French bulldog owners in LA, but this is a relatively new trend. And you just have to adjust with what the conditions are on the ground at the moment. And they're not good, they're just not good. And so she says, I didn't think that somebody was stealing my dog. I thought it was a misunderstanding. So I said, that's my dog, excuse me. And she wasn't listening. And keep in mind, this is midday, this is broad daylight on a Thursday. After being pushed out of the car, the woman who stole the car, stole the dog, got into, Zacharias then stepped in front of the car in an attempt to stop her from driving away. This woman doesn't care, she continues to drive. And so at that point, Zacharias ends up on the hood of the car because this woman continues driving, right?
There's four people in the car. I think a guy might have been driving, but there's three women in the car as well. And the woman took the dog. So Zacharias runs after her, finally when she figures out, oh my God, is she stealing my dog? And she catches up to her at the car, tries to get in, they push her out. She goes in front of the car and the guy who's driving takes off with her on the hood.
So let's go to graphic four. I was like, I'm not letting this car go. So I just held onto the windshield wipers. Before I knew it, we were driving down the block and picking up speed and I was freaking out for my life suddenly. Now she was able to hold on for about a block until the driver swerved. And at that point she fell off of the curb on 9th Street and Grand Avenue in downtown LA. She said that she luckily just got some bruises and some cuts and was not seriously injured. But according to Zacharias, Onyx is a black Merrill French bulldog with a spotted coat and different colored eyes, making him more distinct and more valuable. And so let's take a look at this, I guess, price chart for these dogs. You get a sense of how expensive they are. So for her particular French bulldog, they sell for up to $7,490.
Wow.
Which is, listen, I don't wanna be judgmental and I can't imagine how scared and angry I would feel if someone stole my dog. So I'm not trying to victim blame at all. But for anyone who's looking to be a pet owner, please, please, please consider adopting. Cause like I get it, the French bulldogs are super cute, but there's all sorts of really cute dogs that need homes.
Yeah, and we regret to inform you, of course, this entire story is imaginary. Because we hear from some people that there is no crime, we're just imagining it.
No, Jake, why does TYT insist on covering these stories in the first place.
Yeah, because we don't want people's dogs kidnapped and sold off. That seems pretty bad. So guys, seriously, something went wrong. We've talked about it from time to time on the show. And criminals feel emboldened. Like Oakland is totally out of control. And if you don't believe us and you think the NAACP in Oakland's imagining it, they've asked for more help, more cops. If you think the stats are somehow made up or something, if you know anyone in Oakland, a real person, a working class person, middle class person, poor person, whatever, anyone in Oakland, ask them, okay? And so in LA, crime has gotten way worse, obviously worse. And so this didn't used to happen. It did back in the day, and then crime got way better over many decades, mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm. And now we're back to the bad old days. And we need to figure out exactly what went wrong and address it so that these poor people are not victimized over and over and over again, because they clearly are.